Hello, everyone. Welcome to another hopefully beautiful live stream. We'll see that in the end if it turns out beautiful. What we're going to do today is take a look at performance samples, a full bundle of Conmodo strings. So we are looking at this. Where are we? There's Conmodo. Just let me give you the link and the info so you know what we're talking about. So performance samples came up quite a while ago. And true to their name, they do the put performance back into sampling. So it is, hi from Sweden. Hi, Sam Joe. Hi from California. So Conmodo is a full-blown string library with a focus on fluid motion and legato and sustained patches. Nothing more, nothing less. It may sound limiting at first, but if that truly is, spoiler there, I don't think it is. So we're going to take a look at the library. So if you're interested, it's on intro sale, the full bundle for $3.29 till April 13th. And we'll, after that, go to full price $5.29. So just so you have a basic idea of what we're talking about. And without further ado, let's jump straight in and take a look and listen and see what it does. For this, I already put some of these tracks into my template, but what I want to do is just create an empty instance of Kontakt so we can enjoy the sound right out of the box without any further processing or anything added to it. So let me do that for a second. And also, of course, let's switch to the DAW view. So let me know if there are any issues with sound or picture. Hope everything is working great on your end. So that's the local instance of Kontakt, and we are going to take a look at Conmodo. Why is that not here? That worked great. I moved all the libraries to my slave PC to load them from there, and may have forgotten to put them onto my master. Let me check that for a second. Performance samples. There is no performance samples there. There we go. No. Okay. Then we do it differently. We just use the ones I loaded already, but let me deactivate everything in terms of processing. And I am going to send this to the stereo out directly. So this is the pure sound right out of the box. And meanwhile, in the background, I will just copy my downloaded data of these guys onto my local system to make sure that we can access everything as intended. So for now, let's just dive in and take a look at Conmodo. So there we go. No, there's no break coming, but I just realized that when we want to take a look at the GUI and everything, it's kind of tough to have that sitting on my slave PC in VE Pro. I definitely want to have the libraries on my master here. So I'm just copying these guys to my internal SSD. Luckily, it's not that big in size, so that's an easy fix. So let me create a folder, Komodo bundle. Let's call it like that. So that is copying in the background. So now we are back on track. Sorry for that break. So, but nevertheless, we can already start to play a little bit around with it. And I can also load Oh, dang, that's taking a while to copy over. Okay. That's the sound straight out of the box with no further processing applied. And I mean, we'll still be able to take a look at the GUI by opening up the slave system. So there we go. So this is, it's pretty straightforward. You get four mic positions. Take a listen quickly. That's close. Then you have another close position. Then we have what I would consider as a Decker, and I guess DC does stand for Decker. And last but not least, we have a wide position. The samples themselves don't react to keyboard velocity, so no matter how hard you hit the key, it will always be the same sample. So all the volume and dynamic modulation happens with a mod wheel and CC11 if you want to bring it further down. So let me just do some sweeps from soft to loud. Maybe bring in the mod wheel a little bit more so you can see it. That's the mod wheel right here. So very smooth there in the transitions from and the intensity of the vibrato rises with the rise of the mod wheel. So let's bring in the Decker again and maybe a close position, bring that down a little bit. Finally, you have individual pan controls on the mics. You can send the mics to different outputs in contact, mute and solo for each mic. Additional controls, obviously you can change the dynamic slider from mod wheel to whatever you prefer. It's mod wheel from the initial setting. And the key switch down here on A1 pretty much just switches from legato to sustain. So you can either have sustain or legato on the patch. That's all that is in there in terms of GUI. But that's what Performance Samples is known for. And yeah, simplicity in the interface. And it's not about looking shiny, but all about the sound. So this is what we definitely want to take a look at today, the sound. That's the most important thing. So we just now have loaded the Decca and close position. Sorry for the cracks there. That's because of the streaming. I will try to have that fixed ASAP when the copying is done locally. That should be better. For now, let's add a splash of reverb to these guys. And actually send them where they should go. And there we go. Okay. Goes to strings, and I just have a slight preamp and a low cut at 80 hertz. Just a little bit of EQ on these to make them a little bit more. So one thing that is also typical for performance samples is the pre-delay. So this whole library has a fixed setting of 140 milliseconds. So that means that there is a lag when you live play the instrument. So when you kind of hear the release of the note that sits before the attack. Ba-da! So there is this 140 millisecond lag between hitting the key and the sound of the attack. So it takes a little bit getting used to it. But the reason for that is that it gets you... I don't know what Jasper did there, but it makes the whole experience of the sound more fluent, more... has more motion than traditional sampling and traditional samples. So it's just something special. I would say it's Jasper's magic sauce. One thing I have to mention is what I realized when you load all four mic positions at once, and this on my end is sitting on an SSD, is very powerful in terms of data streaming. But all four mic positions at once, if you look at the contact CPU, and especially when you play more than one patch, like having the full section, it can be very demanding with all four mic positions. And it kind of goes crazy when you accidentally hit two notes at the same time in the legato mode. And the CPU spikes massively with all four mic positions. So what I did for the template is just load the Decca tree And now we should be able to load it locally. So let's see, back to D, performance samples. Yay, there we go. So that was the violin A, was the first one we loaded. So that's the sound straight out of the box without any further processing and no additional reverb. So let's do a little high polygraph. Good to see you. There was a question. No, there's no giveaway today. So the giveaway today is to take a very deep dive into the library and take a deep look at it and then decide for yourself if you're interested in getting it. As I've said in the beginning, it's on intro sale till April 13th. Here's the link, performancesamples.com. Jesper and Performance Samples have always been very straightforward about the limitations of their libraries, so it doesn't necessarily apply to Konmodo as far as I can tell. So let's look quickly. A string library recorded with motion in the sustains, legato, and attack releases. Active bow sustains offer continuously re-expressed vibrato and emotion via performance and editing approaches. Responsive note attacks and meticulously timed release samples derived from units of musical performance. And I think that's the massive difference to other sample approaches. It's derived from performances instead of just sampling single notes. Much in the same vein as Oceania, Konmodo continues along the path of energetic release samples and appreciation of performance source phrase endings as a critical element of the toolkit in its release sample functionality. Bow change legato transitions wrap it all together, and with the entire library recorded Konmodo and musically restless, the result is a breathing ensemble with coherence in phrasing, vibrato, and expression. So now that we have that, we can go back to checking some of the other stuff. So we had the violins one, we listened to the mic position, so let's check out the violins two in comparison. There we go. I just put these on the same channel so we can go back and forth between. Okay, that works, yeah. And that comes preloaded with different mic positions. So to be fair, we should have that on the same mic setting as the violins A. Versus violins A. So violins B are a little bit softer overall and just sound a little bit more easy, for lack of better words. So the violins A have a little bit more bite. I feel like you should write a Lydian happy family. So that's the violins. Let's check out the violas for a moment. Cool thing is that the overall approach and UI and everything is the same throughout. So there's something similar to Bergesen's Belief. Well, I don't have that in my ear right now. But yeah, I was thinking of doing something more elegic, emotional today with that. I think that library is perfectly suited for that. So let's try not to listen to some references, but just come up with something on our own. That with a closed mic. And of course, definitely important to check out the cello is one of the most important for me. I just simply love the sound of cellos, and these are specifically good. Bring the close a little bit down. I mean, honestly, the CPU on this patch right now is not really representative because I have my full template loaded, I have the stream going on at the same time, so my CPU is definitely struggling a little bit at the moment, as you can see. So we're close to 100%, and part of the reason is obviously having the stream at the same time, and so it's not the usual behavior when you just regularly work in your DAW. Another thing to note is that these samples don't go to triple P. So the softest setting on the mod wheel is this volume. Why run from files, not from libraries? Because this is not a Kontakt player library. I forgot to mention that in the beginning. You need the full version of Kontakt to run it. So it's not a player library. So that's the celli. Then we have the basses, and the basses also have some additional instruments. We can take a look at that in a second. First, let's listen to the basses on their own. They are pretty low in octave. So there are other string libraries have kind of the setup that if you play the same octave on the basses, that they just sound one octave below, but these are actually indeed transposed one octave below. So I check out what the closed mics sound on these. The cool thing is definitely the mic positions allow you to dial in a broad range of different sounds depending on what you need. I mean, it will always be the same section size, so you don't make two basses out of four. Unfortunately, I don't really know how many basses actually are in the section here right now, but the mic positions offer you various ways of dialing in different sounds depending on the project needs. So if you need more intimate, a little bit more smaller sound, then just go with a close mix. Or like this, or yeah, the Decca for more kind of classical orchestral seating and sound. So there's no slurs, no slides or anything. It's just a boat legato, just in brackets. But in my opinion, that still gets like 80% of the job done, unless you're specifically looking for short articulations, which this library is not made for. But you still can get a lot of mileage out of that kind of sound. So let's get back to the stuff we have in the template. Same sound, just a little bit of a splosh of reverb there. What I did load into the template here is just for the sake of having that available. And since the sound is close and similar, I did load the fluid charts from performance samples as well, which first and foremost look pretty similar in terms of GUI. So when we look at the, where are they? There we go. When we look at the fluid charts, so it's pretty much the same GUI. It's not four, but three mic positions, but still close Decca wide. So we could theoretically, and I brought the close and wide down all the way. So it's right now it's Decca only. So there is a little bit of a similar sound to the shorts. So it could work to have these work hand in hand. Legato. And then the same thing with the shorts, they have a 127 millisecond delay built into them, so it's a little bit tough to perform them in real time and live and everything, but they just sound gorgeous once they sit on the grid with these 127. I just like the sound. They sound very beefy and organic. So, without further ado, let's see if we can come up with something hopefully beautiful, calming, relaxing. I mean, we all know it's crazy times out there, so let's not go with something that drives the pulse higher even more, but rather look for something that relieves a little bit of stress. So, I would actually say to rather start with some piano. Because honestly, yesterday I was sitting down and thinking, okay, maybe set up an idea before the stream and just go with that. But no, let's start from scratch. I don't have an idea what we're going to do. And I like the idea more of working right here with you guys and see where we can take it. Instead of doing anything prefabricated. Not too bad. Tick, 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 tick. What is that, 90? Pretty much. Okay, let's just lay down a simple piano here. Okay, that's an intro, not too bad. I mean, that's E minor, D, C, D. C major 7, so to say. So, it's nothing too complicated there. Actually, that's 8th notes. I need to quantize that to 8th notes. Sorry. There we go. Sustain is there. Okay, so I would start with a more softer violin. What I did, by the way, just so you know, I flipped the panning on the audio return for these violins. So this is the way they actually sound without the processing, of course. Get rid of that. So. But I do like to have my violins, actually, my second violins, completely turned to the right in comparison to the... The first violins. So I just like the spreading of the first and second violins to left and right. It just, I like that sound more. Maybe not the most puristic approach to orchestration and sound of classical music, but that's not what I'm doing. I still believe as long as it sounds good, it is good. Hey, who we have there? Hello, hello. Hey, D-Man. Okay, I want to start with a very simple pedal note on the violin there. So we are in E minor, so let's play an E. And since that's the quietest we can go, what I have on my iPad here is an XY controller that is linked to expression and mod wheel. So I don't need to do mod wheel and expression at the same time. With that keyboard, but I can do that on an XY pad. So if I go to the right, that's expression only, and if I go up, that's mod wheel. So that gives a little bit more control over the sound. Let's start with that. And as you can see, something's wrong here. Oh, I just realized I made a mistake. I think I may have put expression on. No, I didn't. Otherwise, I wouldn't have recorded CC1 and CC11. It looks pretty similar, so let me make sure that this thing is working correctly. When I record here, yeah, okay, so this is expression. There's also something wrong with the way it works. And in the other direction. Well, there's some issues I think I have with my with sending the data to my DAW. So I need to look into that. Anyway, we can always fix the MIDI a little bit later in case we need it. Goes down a little bit much for my taste. So let me check the comments there. Yeah, there are several ways you can do it. You can have the you can link CC11 to the mod wheel as well. That's true. Bringing it to only 60-100%, for example, so that you don't go all the way quiet. I'm no contact programmer, so I can't really tell you how much that is possible. I'm pretty sure it is possible with jumping a little bit into the GUI, but I can't really answer how, because I don't know. And the XY pad, the app I'm using here is, I don't know if you can even see that. So pretty much it's TouchOSC, and I have my controllers on different pages, and I just added one XY pad to control my MIDI data there. So hope that was visible. I want to have a movement in the viola there. So you're sending via Bluetooth? No, TouchOS uses the Wi-Fi. So you have a little app on the PC that is called TouchOS Bridge. And that is pretty much just a receiver for the data that the TouchOS app from the iPad is sending. So let's see if we can come up with a little bit of a performance, since we are working with performance samples in the something like that. It's just playing around with the chords there. So, as I said, the issue is with that 140 millisecond delay that it's not that easy to play live. But the good news is that you pretty much can hard quantize the whole thing. For example, to eighth notes, and it will sound in sync, unless there are some notes where you completely messed up, like I just did here. So. But when I solo this and go to velocity, and as I said, the velocity actually doesn't really do anything to the samples, it's only the mod wheel that changes the sound. So the only thing that you're going to make sure is that you overlap the notes, so that you get these legato transitions. So. That was an unintended gap. Sounds pretty nice. So. I think the piano can get a little bit more reverb. Shallow below. Okay, you may write a lot of expression on this one. No, actually, let's put the root note in the cello. Just some questions. How nice and flowy. What is the difference between bow change and slurred legato, by the way? Well, bow change is that, as the name implies, that the bow changes on the legato transition. I mean, I'm not a string player per se, so maybe I'm wrong with that. But slurred legato is pretty much that within the bow movement, you move the finger or slide the finger to the next note. So you get this slide transition instead of a new attack by re-bowing the note. So you get ba-da-da-da or ba ba-da-da. I'm not a string player, so sorry for that. But I hope that still makes it clear. Nice to see you streaming so much lately, CloudJumper. Thank you. Today I finally managed to tune in. There you go. Is there a possibility to set a sample start time? I would wish there was, but there isn't, unfortunately. Yeah, a little bit hard to play at 140 milliseconds, but it works. And it sounds... For me, the most important thing is that the result is the most rewarding thing. It just sounds unlike any other library that I know of. It just sounds real. That's what I can say about it. So again, let's lay down some cello. Just the root notes. So, but that's way too loud, of course. So, hard quantize these guys. They are legato transitions. My dog's going crazy outside. Sorry for that. And just going to record some expression on top. Just a little bit of a dynamic bump there. Like a hammer on versus picking again. I don't really get that. So I've read that library is bow change legato all the way. Is that weird? Well, determine for yourself. If you listen to it and it sounds good, is it weird? I wouldn't say so. It's just that this library specifically just focuses on this, to do this, and in a sense to do this good. I want to bump the violas a little bit. And don't have them as jumpy, so let's compress the MIDI data a little bit on the mod wheel here. And you hear that little attack in the beginning. So, and what I also want to do is, but so I turned the mod wheel up a little bit. So I want to have a little bit of a mod wheel in the expression as well. So to have like a little rise and fall on these performances. Come on. There we go. So now. That was a transmission mistake. Yeah, so it's fine. Again, this is what we have so far. So what we could do is just for now duplicate the cello and the basses. I'm not sure if I want to put them an octave down. Yeah, actually, let's try that an octave down. Now we can bump up the volume a little bit on these guys. Bring that in on the second round. So let's get rid of this. I want to just duplicate this part and bring in the solo line on top. I do like that. So I can't really answer the question with you hear every attack on the legato. That's the initial aim of the library, to make that flowing sound. I can only say you either like it or you don't like it. That was a little bit fast. I still don't want to hard quantize that. I like this little da da da. Wanted to do this on this one. What's that yellow button on the track you're using? You mean this one? That is a latency compensation, so it automatically helps to put the MIDI notes where they belong, depending on the track latency. So, is there a way to soften the attack on the fourth node here? Yellow button is toggle time based button. Yeah, right now I'm not really sure what yellow button you're talking about. Auto scroll, toggle time base. Let me know if you want to have further explanations. I try to do that and answer that. So without the piano, just the strings, that's what they sound like. Need to save that. No phrases in this library. So, of course, there's a weird thing happening here due to the copying of the data, which means that the module data here is obviously messed up. I have weird graphic glitches right now. I think that is due to the stream running at the same time. Just wonder how I can fix that. So what I want to do is make sure that there is no jump in the MIDI data here from one transition to the next. Okay. So, oh wow, that's I think it has to do with a video playback on Sorry, you're confused about what? What confuses you? Let us try to help you. So, honestly, I see a restart of Cubase coming. It's kind of behaving weird right now. So, I just want to make sure that the MIDI data is correct here. In these transitions, after we copied or duplicated that part, obviously there is something wrong here in the MIDI. And that dip was very audible, so we are going to try to get rid of that. To have that transition a little bit smoother. Smooth. Same here. Okay, so we should be good now. So when we listen back, just the strings. Wow. So bear with me. What we're going to do is just take a 1 minute break. I give you just the intro screen for now, and I am going to restart Cubase. Something is very odd there. So save it, and I'll be back in a minute. Excuse me. Hopefully. There we go. Okay, see you soon. Okay, so hopefully everything is working a little bit better now. As I've said, template and streaming and all at the same time can get the toughest system into its knees. So, how big is a template CPR file? Not that big. I think 50 megabytes or something. Let me check. So we have template April. So when we look at that, 43 megabytes. Not that big because the main chunk of everything is outsourced to VE Pro. Okay, once again, without the piano, just the strings. One thing I want to change here. How big is the Konmodo bundle? Let me tell you. Performance samples Konmodo bundle. So that means all instruments 9.25 gigs. So 9.5 gigabyte. So I want to change the, yeah, that's good. Change the chords here in the cello and basses. I was actually thinking of duplicating the violas. Let's see what that sounds like if I play the same in the cello. Well, obviously it's a little bit loud, so we can bring that down quite a bit. I think we can even that out a little, so do not have the performance as jumpy there. Greetings from Argentina. Greetings to Argentina. Hope you're doing well down there. Okay, and then let's actually harmonize that thing. So when the cello play that line, then so just want to see how that sounds when the cello and the violas play that more harmonized. That was bad. So we keep that. Just hold the note there. technically we can have the same note there. So no, that sounds bad. Okay, like this. And that also means that now we can actually bring the cellos up a little bit, because now actually do the sixth. Only want to edit this layer. Oh. So. Okay, so that means so let's see what that sounds like. Could be bad, could be good. Okay, so, and the celli. Oh, damn. Just realized I made a mistake. So I changed the, yeah. So what I need to do is go here. I edit the cellis as violas and the violas as cellis. So I just need to change the MIDI parts on that second part. So now it should be better. Kind of wondered why it sounds strange. Okay. And then we go on like this, and I want to raise it a little bit in intensity with the modulation. Something is off here. Okay, now I'm confused. Let's do the cellos alone first. Okay. That needs to. That's the C, okay. So now the violas. Copied the wrong MIDI data there. That's for sure. I think I had it like this. Okay, let's see if that works now together. Actually, let's listen together with the bass so we have the root note. The only thing that's odd is this one. Cello is too dominant there, and viola has not enough beef, so cello needs to come down a little. Okay, like this. Okay, so we have this, then listen to the whole thing with the piano, see what it sounds like. Actually, I do like that, but it's a little bit washy in terms of sound, so I want to try to load the first mic positions on the Komodo. Arken, hey, good to see you. Hope you're doing well. So let's go to my first violin, well, not to these. Go to Komodo. I hope that my system is able to cope with that. So let's load the close, at least on the legato instruments. So I had that off for all the others. As I said, playing all the mic positions at once can be a tad straining on the CPU. But I hope that it's working. See what it sounds like with a close mic position on. Oh yeah, much more definition. And CPU looks still good, so that's fine. And I can also, on the Viola, I should be able to change, the volume. And on the first violin, that volume is way too loud. Close. So we can look into the mic mix, then the initial setting. I'll bring that down a little bit. There was a question on how you learn to write lyrical strings and stuff like that. I can hardly answer the question. The thing is that I didn't learn from books or anything, but rather by just keep doing it, listening to a lot of stuff, trying to emulate stuff that others have done and learn from that, mock up pieces you like. That's the best way forward, in my opinion, to get an ear and a feeling for what works in terms of string. String writing is in and of itself, within being a composer, and I think it's an art form in itself. And I have a lot to learn still to be actually good at it. So I want to lay down very subtle some spiccato strings on top, but I want to be very careful with how much energy they have, so I want them to be very so it sounds just very so that is flute shorts now, not Komodo, but I think the deriving the samples from actual performances instead of sampling single notes really helps to get this kind of flowing feel and the name of the company implies a performance sample, so to have it more feel and sound like a performance instead of stacked samples. And I mean, the first violins bang in pretty much there. Could bring these down a little bit. We don't need them to have them that much in your face. There is a post of this library in, if you mean in terms of giveaway, no, there is no giveaway today, so there is no post for this library today. Okay, we can give it a little bit more. I'll actually take the little bit more one. Duplicate. Duplicate again. I'll move that up. Combine these so Okay. Another. Oops. Sorry. Why is my mic not solo safe? That is unexcusable. And why is my mic not showing up in the mixer? And okay, now it should be solo safe. When I solo this, yeah, okay, good. Sorry, Corona just got me. For a cough, no more. And so then I wanted to change these strings here and actually use the sustain patch. So, just read the page, the library is globally late at minus 80. Set immediate track to this number, Qantas, and you will be on time. If you mean for Caspian, yeah, Caspian I think is minus 80, Caspian Rust, but the strings are minus 140 and the fluid charts are minus 127. So, but yeah, in case you're missing this number, it is always, you can read about that on the performance samples page to look into that. My cam is frozen. This is okay, let me switch off the cam for a second. Move you guys there. And let me quickly check what's up with the camera. And let's see. Camera open. Okay, there we go. Da 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 da. Okay, there we are. Back on track with the camera. So let's see if that works here. No camera. There we go. Sorry for that. But I hope now it's fine again. I just leave me there. So. Now that we have that out of the way, let's go back to the track. So I want to try to use the sustain patches from the violins. Are you the guy that does VST reviews on YouTube like Era 2 Medieval? Yes, that, I mean, there are other guys that do that too, but I have done these as well. Let's record some strings there on top. Okay, so that should make the harmonic structure a little bit more clear. Let's see what the strings sound on their own. ¶¶ hearing something in my head that we can do. Just thinking of how to go into the second or into a second part here. Just sketching out an idea here that I just had. No, there's definitely some issues here and there, I guess, that we need to quantize. But you gotta start somewhere, right? So, see, Craig, I told you, you're famous. The Craig Peters, exactly. my medieval twin, more my evil twin, not my medieval. Okay, let's slam on these soaring violins. Well, what kind of shitty piano did I play here? Holy cow. Okay, I did hard quantize. That is no excuse still. Messed that up. So okay, so the guideline is there. Now let's go again with a strings, do the violin. Okay, let's go.
Thank you.
So, I mean, we go full throttle here, meaning I actually want to have that octave in the first violins, meaning violin A, and do the octave in the second violins, because they're a little bit softer, so I might be afraid that they're a little bit harsh if I do it the other way around. Sorry, that was unintentional. Well, at least let them come in a little bit. Okay, let's go with a little bit of movement in the viola. I mean, there's a lot of work to do in the main line in the violins. We will take care of that in a little moment. First, what I want to do is make sure that these guys are absolutely on the grid. So that's pretty much eighth notes. Okay. Let's see which of all these notes are messed up. Quite. So that was wrong. Actually, it's up, down, up. So like this. Change this to an E. Okay, that sounds good. So next topic will be, let's get rid of the double violin there and let's fix the volumes for the main melody. And also what we need to do, I think, is kind of just mute the whole piano melody on top. So, see what that sounds like. And obviously. Do a little bit of a better job on the quantization part. That needs to overlap. That a little bit forward, have that a little earlier. These guys obviously need to sit further back. Okay, so. Just hearing something more there. Yeah, something like that. Cool thing is with these long notes is that you have a lot of room for like call and response things and doing in between notes with other instruments like the cello, for example. Something like. Okay, so we're getting there. Yeah, something like that. I do like the first movement there. Mm-hmm. Not fully there yet, but I mean, we're just collecting ideas, right? Well, there was some stuff in there that was rather nice. So the first movement, I like that counter movement there in the cellos. Yeah, that one was pretty cool. So you can pretty much move the whole thing there, do eighth notes and quantize. I want to hold that G a little bit longer. Yeah, I want to have that counter movement when the violins hold a long note. I want to have the celli moving. But with that, they land on the same note, so that's definitely... not intentional. See what that sounds like. Empty. Give me empty. Okay. There was a question, how do you set it that the track automatically expands to the height when you're on? It's in preferences, general, I think. No, not general. Editing, project on console, enlarge selected track. So you need to activate that little checkbox. And then depending on the size that you set, every track that you select will jump to the selected size that you have it set to. On we go. Somehow my chat is not visible. There we go. So the harmonics make me feel cry about a situation now, but it's really sensational, this melody. Thank you so much, Arkin. Set track height, we had that. Lower right of screen page, Cubase, there's a slider and arrow, click arrows for options. Hi all, hi DJ, DJ, hello. And also, as announced in the stream announcement, what we will be doing is we take a very quick little sneak peek by the end of the stream into Performance Samples Oceania 2, which is an early alpha version that I just got from Jesper. Thanks for that. And so we can take a quick listen to it, and that part will not be available after the stream. So the video will go up, but not that last part. I will cut that out before that video gets uploaded. Back to topic. Let's listen where we at and what the strings sound like so far in the end. ¶¶ Okay, I was not done with that part yet. I just realized. So that goes there, that goes there. And I want to have that. Yeah, there's a little bit bite there, but I think that's fine. Again, a little bit movement. So let's have that sitting correctly. That actually needs to go there. That will be longer. Third there. I held that a little long there. So, yeah, definitely lay down the harmonies for the bass. No, that's not what I want to play. Some ideas in there. Movement, movement, movement. That was all about. More movement. So. I have these guys sitting. Okay. And we can move. Expression up a little more even. You should finish this track name in something like Heroes and Dedicate to the World as Workers. Well, first and foremost, none of the tracks that I ever do on the stream go to waste. So I don't do the tracks just for the sake of having fun on the stream. So usually I say 90% of every stuff that I do finds its way into my regular workflow. So, thank you. So maybe the bases are a little bit all over the place now, and they need a little bit of taming. So that I went a bit overboard there with the mod wheel. So let's even that out a little bit. But other than that, I think they sound pretty cool. Ethan Livingstone asked what microphone positions. Right now, I'm using the Decker with a touch of close on every legato patch. Funnily enough, I didn't do that. I wanted to do that on the sustain patches as well. So want to use the clone because I used the Decker only before and that was a tad blurry, and so the close mics definitely helped to get a little bit of definition into the sound. So okay, we got this. I actually want to listen to the whole track, so what we have so far, because I forgot what the intro sounded like. Happens when you're working on a track and you get lost amidst some size is 9.5 gigs. That's correct. Just a little shout out on side note. Woodchester, my absolute favorite piano from Fracture Sounds. Okay, there's a few things I'm hearing. How to say, some kind of harmony, but not only harmony. Let's see. That was very bad, but yeah, I'm just collecting ideas again. You use penning on cello and strings? just a little bit on what is given in the GUI of the interface with panning the close mics. The only very dedicated, I mean, what I could do is move the strings a little bit to the left here, the violins A. I haven't even done that. The only dedicated decision I made is the violins B are actually panned to the left a little bit in the close mics, but I flipped the panning in Cubase to have them sit on the right side. Now we see, so the panning right here, I didn't change anything on that. So that's pretty much the preset setting from performance samples, from the way they deliver these patches. I mean, the mic volume is, I brought that down to like -5 or something, but it's still better than just the Decca only. So having a little bit of close mic helps defining the sound a little bit more. Don't forget to save is a good point. So done. Let's save, but it's saving every 5 minutes anyway. What are the key switches controlling? There is no key switches. The only key switch that we have is on A-1 that switches between legato and sustain, which I don't even use because I have sustain and legato separated. Okay, that was weird at best, but yeah, let's see. So we want to edit violin B. Playing the same. Maybe keep that on B. I don't like the octave there. Again, a little bit movement there. Hard to tell what I'm doing right now. I'm kind of hearing something in my head that I just try to... It's a little bit, it's a little bit all over the place. I give you that. So, is there a track delay on these patches? Yes, there is 140 milliseconds for the Conmodo Legato violins throughout. So, only one number you need to keep in mind. Okay, what I may do is just lengthen the whole ending part to have that two bars, I said. Yeah, there we go. And move the modulation down on this one. Down on this one. Down. I mean, I'm very lazy here right now. I just want to kind of bring it to an end. No, you cannot control Portamento. There's no Portamento in this library. It's only boat change legato. High piano note there. Why is that still there? I think because of that one. Okay, let's do a little bit of roll some percussion there. Obviously our most beloved. But we will do a little bit more. That's just taking care of the low end. Oh, the sub. Quantize that. Then let's bring in a little bit of a cymbal roll. It's a little more. Start a little bit earlier and start a little bit more volume. So we have a decent rise there. Yeah, that sounds better. Then we want to have. That one. Let's combine that. Yeah. Just need to get it right to sit right on the one. 2, 3, 4. It's pretty much shortly after the 4, I guess. So need to start here. Come on. I clicked you. Boop. Okay. So let's see if that is sitting where it should. Arkin, I'm using Cubase, but I don't know how to change the notes for what is solfege, solfege? I certainly don't know what I mean. Okay, a little earlier, not later. Yeah, that sounds good. So we just duplicate that with a hand drum. See how that sounds. Okay, last but not least. No. The soft one. Very rumbly. I mean, the music note that can any instrument player read? Do you mean music theory? How to understand music theory? Not really sure what you're aiming for, what you're aiming for. I may favor the idea of putting a solo vocal on top there. Maybe. I mean, it can sit there, but I think it's taking away a little bit from all the string movements and all the stuff we have going on in the strings. So, what I would want to do is just support the harmony a little bit with some just some brass below. And I'm actually doing a quick fix here. Just going with a... So just we have some harmonic framework there. And I think I could also do that with a choir. That's the Oceania one, by the way. I mean, you could go in that direction. No, I'm not going Oceania there. I just want to put some hum chords. These guys want to see you. Okay, there you go. Psst. Okay. So that was Cookie. Sorry for that. No, not Arc 2 Children Core using the Lacrimosa Legatus here. Cookie, come on. And sometimes when he jumps up, he accidentally puts his paw on the computer power knob and just shuts down the whole system. I actually need to put something in front of that so he doesn't kill my workflow. I'm wondering if for the second part of that last section, if we should just add a little bit of horns on top. Always grab something from the trash bin. that he's not supposed to grab. Thing is, I mean, it sounds nice, but does it really need it? The melody is great on top, so let me... Damn it. I'm sorry for that. Did you study music theory? I started, but didn't finish. I didn't really like studying it, so no. Maybe rather a solo horn than a full section. Yeah, let's try that. That's a little bit too quiet, so we need more, but I need a click mostly. Okay, let's try four horns. I mean, yes, you could put a horn on top there to emphasize the last little part of the melody. So let's move that there, quantize that. Why don't you sign with Two Steps from Hell company? Because I have my own company. I'd rather write for my own company than for anybody else. Which is not true. I write for a lot of other people as well. But yeah, Two Steps from Hell is also just a different league. Anybody listen to Thomas' latest track that he presented yesterday? So small yet so big. Great little cue. I love Two Steps. And especially Thomas as a writer. Not a big fan of Nick, to be honest. Funny enough. But, yeah, Thomas' writing is just out of this world. But I think there are not many people out there that compare to what Thomas is doing with music. Do you own sample modeling brass? I do. But I don't like it too much. So someone asked to listen to the strings without the piano. Actually, I want to do that as well. Let's listen to just the strings alone. That was a bad idea, and most importantly, I have no idea why my mic mutes when I solo, for example, the strings or something. So, but anyway. Thank you. So that's the strings on their own. There was one thing, this note in the high second violins, I think, yeah, violins B. That doesn't really work. Yeah, I think we need to do like this. That's pretty cool. I like that. So, but yeah, we have a little bit piano in the track as well. So show me just everything that has data. There we go. It's actually not that much, but it sounds pretty big. And last but not least, what I want to do, as I have promised, at the end of the stream, we are going to take a quick sneak peek into Performance Samples new Oceania 2 library that's coming out sometime this year. I got an early alpha version to play around with, so we can take a quick listen in a little bit. But for now, that shall conclude writing a little bit with Konmodo. So my thoughts. What are my thoughts on Konmodo? I definitely love their approach on doing things differently in terms of getting more performance out of the samples. I mean, hence the company name, Performance Samples. It helps to create the illusion of a actual performance way more easy than with traditional samples. And if I were to choose between using Konmodo, for example, or Cinematic Studio Strings, or pretty much any other string library that is out there, I don't know of any library that compares in terms of when you massage the data that sounds the same as Konmodo does. So it just sounds brilliant. But it also has its limitations, of course. So first of all, usually you need to do a few more articulations, like shorts. I mean, you have the flute shorts that technically could work with the same library. So to have it as a fully grown string library, I would love to see at least the basic articulations covered, like pizzicato, spiccato, tremolo, maybe some trill, stuff like that, with the same player seating and settings and mic channels and stuff like that, so you have the same sound for these other articulations. But that does not exist yet, and it blends very well with other libraries, so you can also layer. But in terms of sound, there is nothing, in my opinion, that compares to it. It just sounds amazing. Either right out of the box or also with some massaging and some additional settings and tweaks. It's really a fantastic library, in my opinion. It sounds great. It is steep, of course, but on the other hand, if you think about the fact what you need to pay for a decent string quartet or a string library, string orchestra to record your stuff live, this kind of bridges the gap a little more from working in the box to live musicians. It will never replace a live section, of course not. But it brings us closer to sounding a little bit more like the real thing and maybe fooling the listener's ear. And in the end, for me, that's something that is very important to me to get a sound out of my box that gets as close to the real thing as possible. So with that said, let's give a final listen to that cue we did today. You say finish on stream. I think there is not much more to finish. That cue is just, fine for me now. I don't need to do a 3:30 version of that. I think it portrays portrays the point of what this library is about and what it can do, what it can sound like, at least what I can make it sound like with my limited ability. So, but I think it sounds pretty nice. And in the end, that's what it's about.